My name is Ellis Gallagher. I'm a Brooklyn-based visual artist based here in Greenpoint, Brooklyn. My signature style would be my shadow outlines in the street. I guess my bikes I do a lot, especially particularly my own bike. It's just something I enjoy doing. I'm in the process of trying to brand myself in that way where it's like a familiar image you see and you could automatically make the association with the artist. In 2005, I started doing the shadow outlines. I felt like an instant response. With creating the work, my work in the street, people are talking about it immediately. People are seeing it. It's not like where you make a painting and then it's just sitting in your studio. You have to try to get a show in a gallery. I'll take a picture before and it's nothing. You know, it's just like a mailbox. People walk by it a million times a day. Then I go and do it, people stop and like, oh shit, I walk past this thing a million times a day and never stop. This. That's great, that's awesome. Once I started feeling that, like getting that response, I was like, this is where I have to take my shit. Because I'm just wasting my time making paintings that nobody sees. I'm going out in the street and I'm creating work that everybody sees. You don't have to even follow art or like art. It just kind of went from there. Went from getting response in the street to making some prints, you know, making photographs of the stuff, doing installations, taking what I do outside and bringing it indoors. When it's in the gallery, now it's an installation. It's contemporary art now. It changes, it becomes different once you take it away from its original element. It kind of loses a little bit because it's not in the street when it's in the gallery, but the best place for it, I think, is in the street. People know me as just the guy who does the shadows. There's a lot more work that entails just outlining a shadow and taking a photo. It's all situational because a lot of my work is in the street. I look for background, color, what the object is, what the color of the streetlight is, location. If it's during the daytime, make sure it's clear. Not cloudy, so I get a good strong sunlight that casts shadows. How big is the object I'm doing? Or if I'm bringing the objects with me, like milk crates, or nighttime and make sure it's not raining. Sometimes like I'll even go out right after it rains because I photograph everything. You know, with this wet streets, you get nice glares of light. You know, if I'm working at night, I tend to use brighter colors, yellows, oranges, reds, pinks, whites. So I make sure I have those colors. Whereas during the day, I'll go darker because you can see it better. Because I have a list of locations that I sometimes return to more than once. Or I'll pick a neighborhood. I'll be like, okay, tonight I want to do the Lower East Side. Okay, I'm going to rock Chelsea tonight. Then I'll just go and just do systematically every corner. I want gallery people to see my stuff, so I'll do it in Chelsea. Or I'll go in front of the MoMA. Or I'll go in front of PS1. I just want to try to make a little noise. This is Ellis Gallagher, aka Ellis G, and this is my 120 seconds. I'm gonna talk about common sense and respect. I think very important to be respectful of yourself first and foremost, and respectful of people around you. The NYPD should reassess their priorities and you know, not police people for, you know, people such as myself in my instance for chalking sidewalks. If you see it's just sidewalk chalk, that's what it says on the box. It's sidewalk chalk, it's for the sidewalk. It says ages 3 and up. I think that police should exercise common sense. I don't know if, you know, if there are law enforcement officials watching this now, but it is legal to draw on the sidewalk in New York State. So I think that, you know, you should just ease up on people who do that. A lot of people are confused and a lot of people don't know the difference between what graffiti is and what street art is. It's two entirely separate things. You know, graffiti is like a name-based, letter-based art form with tags and throw-ups and fill-ins and pieces and productions. That's a graffiti thing. Street art is stuff other than graffiti. There are some people that blur the lines and kind of straddle the fence on what constitutes graffiti and what constitutes street art, because, you know, there are people that do character-based works, strictly, and they've used spray paint and paint markers and permanent marking devices. That's another thing what graffiti entails, is stickers and spray paint. Works in spray paint, works in paint marker. You know, street art is more like installation and stencils and wheat paste, which is separate, and it's more like imagery as opposed to a letter-based art form. So there is a big difference between the two. Street artists should respect graffiti and not go over graffiti. You see a bunch of tags on the door, you just throw up a wheat paste and cover everything. I bet you like 9 times out of 10 a graffiti writer will walk by, and if their tag was on that door, they would be peeling that poster down. But be respectful of people, of other people's artwork, and don't go over it. My name is Ellis Gallagher, aka Ellis G. That was my 120 seconds. Remember to use common sense and be respectful. Peace.
Many ask for something honest, loving heart with someone new. And love, only thing that's promised love to my heart, the only thing that's hard love to embrace, only thing that makes life worth living. Seems love is here to stay. Seems love is here to stay. I remember the first time love touched my heart. Memory of that day. Delicate touch, long, warm skin, long, warm. Breeze sang softly, and I trembled beneath your touch. As I trembled, love escaped.